Thanks for tuning in to my official YouTube channel. Today is the 25th of June, 2022. Make sure to subscribe to my official YouTube channel, like my official YouTube videos, go to my website, www.susanmealy.com, which is the same as www.ladydorybell.com. So, I have been making a few official YouTube channel videos of mine, and I have updated since the year 2019, regarding my journal blog, the Order and Peace site. In conjunction to that, I also have offered a few more books, and if you go to the book section of my website, www.susanmealy.com, you can see some of the books that I have added. So for one example, there's the 3-volume book series, The Adventures of Susan Mealy, SCUBA Diving, Extraordinaire. There's a few other book series that I've added a couple of books to those series and those particular references, and since I have the capability of distinguishing the difference between those particular factors as two different genres, there are the reasons why I distinct between the different genres, because I have been able to categorize that in reference to my authoring and compiling my books and my different book series. I've done the best that I can. So in reference to The Adventures of Susan Mealy's SCUBA Diver Extraordinaire, in one particular reference is to, other than having earned my 26 SCUBA diving certifications in the year 2009, yes, I am a registered qualified. However, I don't allow those particular political affiliations to officially compound anything that I've worked to do. So, for example, even though I'm a registered Republican, despite that, I did not vote for who became President of the United States of America in 1944, and the same in regards to the Vice President of the United States of America, the term President of the United States of America in 1946. I did not allow my political viewpoint to impact or anything in reference to my work. I did the best that I could. I handled as much as I could on the time frames of, more specifically though, in regards of the year 2009, when in regards of the 26 SCUBA diving certifications I earned, the work that I had began. In a more official context through scuba diving certifications, than the comparison of my childhood and my young teenagers is to different training that I've had learned, I suppose is one way to put it, as to some of the factors that I've authored about in different references. And there are plenty of discussions I've had in person, face to face, in person, regarding my childhood. Some people may have thought whatever they had thought in comparison to reality. So in regards of my childhood, my biological mother and my biological father, well, they would be capable to clarify my babysitter and her husband, regarding some essential USA, who had been my babysitter and her husband. My babysitter's husband had been a director of security at the World Trade Center, the World Trade Center Plaza. And both of them were from island areas and had spent a lot of time in those capacities. Obviously, the oceanic waters nearby. Then you have the conjunction aspects as to my bakon and my bakpu. But specifically, though, my bakpu having had certain training, that it is as it is in those particular references, that's a different type of training. Work. As anybody who would either know information about China and or have traveled there, I haven't traveled there. I've known a little bit from what I've read as well as what I've been informed of regarding my bakon and my bakpu. There's a few areas where there's water. There's a couple of
could be.
That could be the area. There could also be an area called the Indian Ocean. I'm not certain 100%. There could be. I have looked at a map before. So there is this class I've taken a few times, depending on the grade, as to this. I don't know if anybody's heard of this class. It's called geography. And so I don't want to assume that anybody else has had a geography class, or a few, depending on the grade. So in that particular reference, yeah, there's a couple of situations. So more along the lines in reference to the Atlantic area of the ocean waters, my biological mother and biological father would be capable to acknowledge in reference to my baby sibling and husband, as well as my bunko and my bunko. My biological little sister may have acknowledged that as well, though, you know, obviously being my biological little sister, there's obviously a difference to the amount of time and the training capacities. And you can tell in reference to personality, because individuals who have certain types of training tend to be a certain way. People who don't have a certain type of training, they tend to be a different way in that capacity. So, you know, those who have had certain types of training, they may have a type of background. Well, that's cool that they have that background. Though you can tell in the personality traits, in my opinion, as to certain particular factors, in that comparison to people who didn't have that type of training, you know, in certain factors. So despite how some may have thought that my biological and maternal sister and I were raised in the same lineage, there's also factors in school training. So one big difference is, and those who have certain backgrounds as far as certain NOSs, I would guess to be there would be certain similarities. And if there are siblings or close-aged or closest cousins, well, I took gymnastics and taekwondo. And my biological little sister took dance. There could be a bit of a difference. Here's another example. So I had not wanted to be a cheerleader, and I was on the track and field team. My biological mother later was like, "I'm gonna be a cheerleader." So when I learned what the rules were, as soon as I could complete certain things, I was no longer a cheerleader. In comparison, my biological little sister had been a part of hobbies while being in tops. There could be some personality aspects as to us that you have a difference. And so, cousins of ours may have had whatever opinions they had, so my biological little sister and I. So one of our oldest cousins would be our biological mother's half-sister, Chris's daughter, and well, there's that factor. She had to go to college in Canada because, you know, art schools in the United States of America, whatever in that capacity. I'm sure there are some art schools that are fairly predominantly good enough in the United States of America, and I'm sure in other areas, yes, there is as it is, but my biological mother would know about her houses. And so there's that, and then there's our other and sensitive situations. And my biological little sister would know far better in comparison to myself as to those factors, those references. And then in regard to my biological brother's brother, regarding Leonard, then there are, what is it, Sarah Elizabeth and Esau. When did that occur? Which my biological father, who was driving, just started laughing. And he was like, oh, he'll learn why. Which I'm fairly certain I might not be the only person who has that sort of an understanding. That was one of those. When did that happen? And so that was when I learned that. in charge, they are. She was like 7 or 8 years younger than me, so it was one of those things. So, and I got one baby cousin that's 7, 8 years younger than me, and I have, or maybe 9 years younger than me. Then I have my cousin Jade, who I was much closer in age to him, but we're only 2 years, maybe 3 years apart, and we got along. So now it's the year 2022. So yeah, I made attempts to explain to people in Asher Holmes Elementary School about my cousin Jane. And so when I made attempts to explain, they automatically thought she was Chinese or that she was Caucasian. And it was, well, you're only half correct. And the she's half Chinese, but the other half is, and they were like, yeah, like you. No. I mean, yes, but no. And so I didn't ever get to the point where it was, no, she's half African American. So we don't look anything alike at all. Yeah, I know the difference. So that was doing her hair. So it was one of those, what does that have to do with anything? And by the way, I was allowed to do her hair. Let me just clarify that, because I was allowed to do her hair. It wasn't like, you know, it was, I was allowed to do her hair. However, because of being half Chinese, it was one of those, I had to explain certain regards to grandmama's friends who were only accustomed to doing African American hair in comparison to African American mixed with Chinese hair. And so there were certain situations it was as it was. Anyway, I've called myself a mutt, you know, because I was born in the year of the dog. So it is as it is. She's more purebred by technicalities, even though she wasn't born in the year of the dog. I'm more of a mutt because I'm only half Chinese and the rest is half with a whole bunch of other stuff. She's more purebred mutt because, you know, she's half Chinese and half American. But she wasn't born in the year of the dog. As it is, nonetheless. Main cousin I grew up with and spending time with, and then because of her family second cousins, the majority of them are African American or African American mixed with Caucasian. And I look as I do. So, you know, by the time in the state of Texas, my hairstyle and my hair color became as pale as of my tattoos, I was one of those, you know, and I was born and raised in New Jersey, and I grew up going to New York and the five boroughs. And
you know,
those people seem to think that my only cousins were looking as my cousins now in comparison to the cousins I grew up hanging out with. And so then I usually, before I could ever actually explain, similar to elementary school to a degree, though in that difference, we know how people are from New Jersey. Migraines of that memory deficit and cognitive disorder. I don't remember all of my cousins in reference to their names. I remember my cousin Jade, which is, you know, my closest related cousin. But I don't remember all of the family coins up because I will use a garment term. Okay? Her dad was prolific. Okay? And Grandmama and Grandpapa had a few children, and so some of the males were prolific. Okay. And so, you know, it was as it was, and so, that's pretty much the only terminology I got for that reference. And so, there we go on that. So it was as it was. Looking back now in the year 2022. Anyway, so in regards of when people such as my biological little sister, which she didn't spend time with my cousin Jade except for in very limited capacities. She didn't meet my cousin Jade until she was in first grade. So it was similar to all the rest of the cousins, only flipped. So where I grew up hanging out with my cousin Jade and my other cousins, my biological little sister didn't even know that they existed. And then when she was first introduced to my cousin Jade, I was all like, hey, what's going on? And, you know, all excited. And then my biological little sister was because I thought she could remember, you know, cousin Jane. And I don't remember her meeting any of the other cousins, but it was as it was, except for Helen, or Granny Helen, and whatever her husband's name, getting that, unless she remembered that. But if she didn't remember that, or if she barely remembered it, most likely she would have remembered it as someone that Mike had done business with in comparison to Taylor. And so then there's that factor to awkward. However, it is as it is. So, you know, I got called racist, which I didn't understand why I would be called racist. I also don't know how to prove that in regards of not being. So it is as it is. I guess if you actually make an attempt to, you might. Just one of those, yeah, well, you know, at that particular early Thanksgiving dinner, one of those, I don't understand why you could have given me that. You married into that, so that makes sense. My opinion. Personal opinion, it is as it is. You know, that exit 200 Starbucks situation. You know, because that's not halfway between Carrollton, Texas and San Marcos, Texas and Exit 200 in the Pride Outlets area. That's only something a certain type of viewpoint would be in that comparison, you know. And so it is as it is, nonetheless. So, I didn't really see any big deal regarding that. I enjoy driving, so, you know, see me, I have a bumblebee car, and that's fine. All of the irony of it was, so did you two see his infection? No, I don't have any desire, want, or need to actually be introduced at that point in time, to be quite honest. I had said especially to, in that particular situation, in that hypothetical, if that was that, where, you know, she drives long enough, she'll whatever, in comparison to, you know, as if you just didn't want to meet them. It's pretty much what it was. It's not my fault. You know, you can evaluate yourselves at that time frame as to why you would know, or as if you didn't want to be introduced. Could you make a movie card? So anyway, you know, it has nothing to do with physical appearance at all, although some people have wondered back in the year 2008, 2009, and 2010 why Zippy was a girl, and it was one of those because she's a girl, and that's just what it is, or she's a female. But my bumblebee car, VW Beetle, you know, black, convertible top, black leather interior, yellow exterior. And, you know, and I knew she was a girl, officially, and scuba diving is when I realized she was a girl. Because I watched her attitude when I saw male scuba divers wearing yellow. I watched her little attitude. That was when I knew Sydney was a girl. I mean, I figured she was a girl to begin with. But when I saw how my little bumblebee car had responded to some of these scuba divers in yellow wetsuits, I watched her little. And so I knew she was a girl. She was fine with any other wetsuit, except when she would see people in the yellow wetsuits. She would just kind of, I'd watch her as to how she intended my little bumblebee car, and she would kind of do it, you know, certain types of do where it's sort of thing, and it was okay. Which is irony because I dated a male who had worn a yellow I was looking at and car up there, and so which is funnier because I learned about this movie called Bumblebee. And so there are certain similarities. I have to acknowledge that. And so she had her limo on. Although it was funny whenever he missed a shot as to what her eyelashes would do. She'd literally just be as far as it was like. I'm not saying her color got brighter, you know, because you're not wearing your yellow onesie. However, what I am saying is she is as she is, which I don't think he really understood what I had meant at that time, although the irony. So then was my thought of the last movie I had seen, and it was one of those, what does the Exorcist have to do with anything right or Dark Knight, which one? Like, is there, I think I saw another movie, I can't remember what it's called though, but you know, that's concerned. Anyway. I know I did see a couple of movies after that, although it wasn't in a movie theater, it was on the television. I just can't remember what they were called. It is as it is. And then, so yeah, it was as it was. So anyway, in those particular references, those situations were as they were. I think it was Bewitched Ever After again, after the Dark. Anyway, those situations, I don't think that's what and then, there's another movie, there was this song, I think it was a Drew Barrymore movie, because what was it, there was a song, video something or other, the hip-hop, something, you know? And so it was as it was, but if the politics had ever mattered to me in comparison to other people, I wouldn't have earned the scuba diving certifications as I had. And I wouldn't have done the work that I had to do. So I found in a particular reference some forming underwater volcanoes. And anybody who knows how land formations are in regards to the oceanic water areas, if you similar to stalactites and stalagmites, though a different coloration, and you'll see bubbles coming out of them as they kind of form. In that reference, you'll kind of over, depending on the amount of and those particular situations, those factors, over time, that will form similarly, especially with the sand dunes and sandbars that start popping up and expanding from certain areas, that will slowly start to, and whatever you consider slowly in that reference too. So in that time frame, it'll go to conglomerate, for lack of a better terminology, and you have the equivalent of the starting point of some of Hawaii's islands as to how those literally started to begin forming. And so if it mattered to me in reference to the specific sense to the political factors in comparison, I wouldn't have done the work that I completed. But so that particular area, sometimes what I do know is in some areas you start having sinkholes more often because what's occurring is the volcanic eruptions underneath the oceanic waters are causing vibrations to weaker areas, and so those sinkholes start to formulate more and more often. And while you can do certain things to a degree to mitigate some of the situations, depending on where they formulate, so for example, I have earned my cavern scuba diving certification Springs 1 and Peacock Springs 2 in Florida, I believe in the Orlando area. And so in that particular reference, if the cavern areas started getting smaller because of the sinkholes in other areas and those particular factors, it's probably because of the vibrations from the underwater forming volcanoes as they're sending up water. Probably going to be nothing that would be pouring out of that vicinity. The temperature would probably be about 150 to 250 degrees, I would guesstimate, you know, with the Atlantic area, the waters in that vicinity. And if you already have an island or two semi nearby within probably about 300 to 500 nautical miles, you have kind of that formation literally watching at this particular point in time as it develops. And so if you had in a different vicinity, so if you have more than one area where sand dunes and sandbars are formulating, that's for those who understand the, it's not really an etch-a-sketch sort of way. It's really a bad term. But it kind of works because for those who have used etch-a-sketch, if you make it really dark in certain areas, then you just lightly shake it in that reference, you have that viewpoint as to some of the situations that are occurring in lack of better specific terminology. And so where those areas that have the forming, that already have islands to depending on the climate, of course. So, in those particular regards, that's what I took pictures of in the year 2009 out from Boca. And so, if it had mattered as to the elected official political party, I wouldn't have done the work that I had to make sure that the land could actually form, because there are the realities that some may not have known about. And so, well, there's what I call bad mar people, good mar people, because of lack of better wording. And then there's the Tic Tac video for one reference, there's the Big Loop for another reference. It's just situations. And I don't remember if any of those particular factors landed in the oceanic water. So I just like took care of a few things so that way that wasn't a problem for lack of better wording. And so those particular situations, especially with the formation of new land, you know, it doesn't matter who's in office at that point in time, really. Of the safety and security aspects, in my opinion. And so, while some people have cared about political affiliation, have only been the ways regarding, you know, X200 type, in that comparison to myself, I, you know, don't care about those political affiliations because I'm more concerned about humanity. In comparison to those types. And so, it's my personal opinion. I've dealt with a few things, so I can acknowledge there are reasons that I can agree with certain democratic viewpoints. And then, you know, I'm more Republican in those references. So, however, if it had mattered, at that point in time, especially depending on the speed of the development. Well, it's about to be 13 years at this point. So if those forming volcanoes I found out from Boca, about half an hour, 45 minutes to an hour and a half on a boat, a speedboat ride, then most likely if they have started, if they have gotten tall enough to be capable to see from surface water area as to within the normal open land, scuba diving, then in those references by now, let's say in 5 years from that point, so let's say it was 2009 to 2014, if you could see that, it's a rapid development as far as that's concerned regarding noise that's been built up in the city. If there is other areas along the East Coast where the expansion of land mass has occurred, despite certain sinkhole areas, that's another factor to take into consideration as to those areas of forming underwater volcanoes. Because those forming underwater volcanoes are essentially going to not necessarily be those on surface Hawaii, where you have actual volcanoes. It'll, depending on the overall acidity as to the composition of the soil, depends on whether or not after a certain point in time it'll stop erupting. And it'll be a bit of an earthquake to a degree. If you have certain, terminology would be if you have any pipes that pour into a certain area and they have similarly to underground caverns kind of gotten smaller and the flow is slower, then in that reference, most likely you have that area where it's forming more rapidly. And so the is kind of a foundational point where it is, that would be about the extreme of the, what could be considered as a fundamental shock. So I've authored a few journal blogs in reference to my website, the Winery PSA, in reference to how coral reefs act as a foundation continental shell to different continents as well as islands. And they do have a protective aspect where they keep land above sea level. And so in that reference, if in that regard you already had taken those pictures in the year of 2009, then you have pretty much a landmark to a degree as to what would be considered a little bit of the bottom area and the ways that that occurs to keep those areas safe as to keep the land above sea level once it officially fully forms. So if you have the conjunction of the sandbars and sand dunes that have slowly been making their way outward into the Atlantic area of the oceanic waters, and it's getting closer to the areas where I had taken the pictures of the forming underwater volcanoes, if they had started to actually, let's say, in the year 2014 or 2015. If you have that, then essentially you have a guesstimation as to how far out that particular area of land is going to develop in those particular states within the United States of America. So that's a quick little-ish brief on that. And so, you know, I just found those. So, you know, I had to do a little bit of work, and it didn't really matter who was president and vice president of the United States of America at the time in reference to political affiliation. I cared more about the hypotheticals, if I was accurate in those references, as to making sure And so after that time frame of 13 years, though more specifically at the 10-year mark, where I had informed people throughout the state of Texas, though also in the state of Illinois, that certain situations as to factors of sometimes it takes 10 years, sometimes it takes 15 years, sometimes it takes 20 years, sometimes it takes 25 years, regarding certain situations, regarding the release of information, and unless there's an actual reason, which you have to have certain knowledge regarding that particular protocol, though I also don't know how long that's been since anybody's had to actually deal with that in that comparison. And that was back in 2008. This is the year 2022. So if in that reference individuals, because of how election cycles are, if that's been something that kind of over time, what have you, yeah, I know there's a specific protocol and because of you have to be honest. And so if you choose to play needless games or you want to stir up needless drama, well, that's not the way to do it. That's incorrect. And usually what occurs when that happens is a bunch of stuff gets flushed out, which does assist in other capacities. I mean, when in the time frame of 2020, President of the United States of America, Donald J. Trump, was in office, the paperwork was signed in reference to the formation of the United States Defense Space Force. Now, there's also the factors of the year 2004 in my backyard in San Antonio, so I don't know how long that actually had been worked on, though in that reference of common sense, again, one and only person to actually speak with in comparison to those other types of situations, which, you know, if you want the actual viewpoint of respect and etiquette, well, certain factors hypothetically wouldn't be considered in those references. went to one tea party event. One, and just one. Wasn't a multitude, and the only time regarding 2020 was only because and since I was taking care of all the stuff that I was taking care of at that time, obviously different, though similarly to 2008, where it was just one event. Just one. Not a whole bunch. Just one. Just one event. I'm not really into politics, because I don't like dealing with that sort of needless drama. Certain individuals who think that, you know, oh, maybe this physical look, in comparison to ever thinking there's enough in the background already. In comparison, because, you know, if you went and spoke with my biological little sister and my biological mother, and or they saw that and they were like, oh, Sam, it's finally getting into balance sex! No, 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 I'm not. You know, it's the equivalent of, oh, Sam is wanting to be a cheerleader! Or, no. Not, no, 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 no. No, not interested in that. So it's a personal preference. Yeah, and I just really don't like dealing with that. I've already dealt with enough politics. This is why I didn't go in as an officer. You know, I didn't want to deal with that sort of stuff. And so, you know, as I said, it's very serious. So I'm fine, truly. Oh, she can win it.
So if anybody ever brought that up, and, you know, especially in the what's supposed to be consenting adult lifestyles, I'm like, oh, a great, you have no idea. not only, I mean, you know, sure, I mean, I obviously cannot out-trump 45, no, I can't do that. I'll die, you know, for all of those people who complained about 45 squirts. Well, since my updates from my journal blog, the Ornery PSA, on my website, www.susanneling.com, the same as www.bell.com. Do you like my words still? However, that needed to be clarified and verified for a few reasons. Having to bring that forward, you know, I've been working on my medal of honor, our project, and again, similarly to my SCUBA diving, if I had cared about the factors of, well, as far as political affiliation, well, I probably wouldn't have begun my medal of honor, our project trips, during the time frame 44, I probably would have waited. But since I didn't, so similarly to myself. you know. So, hopefully those clarifications and verifications to my journal on the ordering USA on my website, www.susanmiller.com, which is the same as www.libertorial.com, have assisted in those clarifications and verifications, no matter who. June 2022.